Hello, everyone. I think, yeah, some time ago, last year, I did a review on my magical talking Hermione that I'd gotten from eBay that I fixed. I did a review on how to fix her to get her talking, and it was pretty much, I've got her back piece off, but it was pretty much about fiddling with that little tab down in there. Let me see if I can zoom in on it. And focus it. There it is. The little tab right below the spring. And it's pretty much just about pushing that thing here. You know, I have something right here, and it was pretty much about fiddling with it. You know, sticking something in there and pushing it down and stuff. So, and I got her working. I actually got her working. Because she didn't work when I got her. So, I recently purchased a brand new one on eBay in the box. And I'm keeping the box she comes in. And my phone is spazzing out again. See if I can focus in on her face for you. She is very, very new looking. She's very pretty. Very, very pretty. And her outfit, her little shoes. And I haven't taken her hair out of the zip ties yet. I thought that was so unique how they did that, because in the box she was displayed. And they actually had these in two zip ties so it would display her hair, which her hair is so soft. It is so very soft. I'd forgotten how soft Barbie hair was back then. But yeah, this doll is from Mattel, the company that produces Barbie dolls. So yeah, I'd forgotten how soft Barbie hair was back in the day. She's from 2002, so yeah. Her hair is so very soft. I mean, it is silky. It's like it just got shampooed and conditioned. It's just so nice. Such nice quality. But I'm going to be going over how to make her talk today. Hopefully this will go the way I plan it to, because it did for the other one. So I'm going to set the camera right there. And just expose the battery compartment here. Yeah, see, the difference between them is the tab back there is folded, kind of, and it's pointing downward. Unlike this one, which I, you know, you see it. I straightened it out. I'm not sure if that really makes any difference, but I'm going to be trying to fix her. I took my old, this one, well, she's not old, but anyway. I took her batteries out, the one I got last year, and I put them in her. So, and she is not working still, but I haven't messed with the tab yet. So, I'm going to be sticking this down into there. And there was like, here's her back piece, and there's a hole down in that area on the piece, and that's where a Try Me tab thing was. So I imagine that's probably the issue with these, but anyway. Let me see if I can get that thing down in there and push on it. Let me see. Yeah, see, I'm kind of pushing up on it a little to straighten it out like I did the other one. So push up on it like that. And I'm using this fingernail file thing because it's got a tip on it, so I can use that. And now I'm going to actually attempt to push down on it. Oops. So see, I am pushing down on it. Pushing down on that little tab right there. So I'm going to continue doing that. Oh, I got her working. Yeah, and see, the tab is touching the bar right here, and now she's not working. So the thing has to be separated from that. Otherwise, she's not going to work properly. So, I just got her talking. Now let's see if I can finish up here. I'm pushing this thing down. Yep. So now she is talking. Not sure if you can hear that very well, but it fixed her. She is working now. So I hope you guys enjoyed that little video on how to fix one of these, if you might have one. So, yes, see, if you can see in there, the little tab is not exactly touching the middle bar where the spring is anymore. The tab needs to be completely kind of separated. You know, it can't be touching that bar, otherwise she's not going to work. So, it fixed her, so. And she is talking, so I'm so happy that I got her working. So, thank you guys for watching. And don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe.